tamad po.
Okay, so okay naman yung kanyang ano ba siya? Medyo ano siya ngayon?
May diagnosed with dyslexia, ADHD, and may bipolar with okay. depression po, Mr. Chair.
So yun yung mga karamdam.
Yes.
Seven, eight, nine, or ten.
Mr. Chair, referring to the appointment po na hired sa PCSO
consultant,
and paid by PCSO.
Whatever, position, yeah. appointed as secretary, or
more or less
whatever.
Five, I'm sure more than five, Mr.
Seven.
Chair.
Seven. And one of those is your daughter. Am I correct? You appointed her as confidential agent. Yes or no?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
You appointed your daughter who is a confidential agent. Meaning of confidential agent. Yes, why did you appoint her?
Mr. Chair, during that time, ang diagnosis niya is
told us.
That is actually
and what's the reason why
hindi naman po ibig sabihin nali ano po ang dyslexia, lumabas lang po yung bipolar niya after na po after I left PCSO.
Okay. Do you know the qualifications of confidential agent?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
What are the qualifications of confidential agent? Tell
someone,
me.
Someone you could trust on
matters. I will tell you the qualification of a confidential agent. One, a bachelor's degree in criminal justice. Two, may experience siya. Previous experience in law enforcement. Meron ba siyang experience sa law enforcement? Your daughter?
I'm not aware of that.
You're not aware? You're together with her for 23 years in New York. Hindi ka aware siyang experience? Meron o meron? Wala.
None, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Anong skill niya? Yung analytical skill niya? Ability to analyze information in order to be a confidential agent?
She's very competent in report writing, Mr. Chair, in editing communications.
10-8. Sige. Okay. So, basically, she's sick, but you appointed her as a confidential agent.
Mr. Chair, if I may.
Yeah, go ahead.
Dyslexia is not a disease. It is a learning disorder, but she was able to overcome it. Mr. Chair, and continues po yung therapy niya during that time. She's very brilliant in communication. In fact, she writes articles in their school po siyang gumagawa during that time na nasa high school siya, Mr. Chair.
Pero may experience ba siya bilang law enforcement as confidential agent?
I feel naman po na
those are the qualifications that written for the confidential agent. Okay. How about Marie Louise Sejorales, yung first cousin mo?
Yes, and, Mr. Chair.
Okay, she was also in PCSO, correct?
Yes.
Anong
Mr.
position
Chair.
Ang lagay mo sa niya?
I think she was appointed as a nurse, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so siya rin ang lagay mong in charge sa mga pagkain doon, correct?
No, Mr. Chair.
Hindi mo siya nilagay?
No.
I will be asking ask the official of the PCSO to be in here. Si attorney sa AGM Gabuyo, si attorney Insyong, yung HR manager natin, si attorney Pakera, and all other PCSO official who were invited. Si Doris Garma, yung sister-in-law mo. Ano naging position niya doon sa yung asawa ni Chuck Garma? Ano naging position niya sa PCSO?
Sa admin po siya.
Sa admin.
Nailagay ko po siya sa
okay.
admin po.
Si Howard Chair. Mansan, yung iyong first cousin sa mother side, saan mo nilagay?
Consultant po sa IT, Mr. Chair.
We have invited also Howard Mansan. Andito ba si Howard Mansan? Can we ask him to be present in here as well? Very important tong si Howard Mansan. Ha? Consultant siya ng IT. Mother side, first cousin ni GM Garma. And si yung asawa ni Howard Mansan, did you appoint her?
She's my private secretary.
Correct.
Mr.
Si Irene Mansan.
Yes.
So she was also present or appointed as a official of the PCSO. How about yung asawa ng first cousin mo na si Emmy Ubales?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
She was also appointed.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. And how about Junjun Ubales?
He was
naka-detail
sa iyo. Security, Mr.
Si Junjun Ubales ay ang cousin mo who was detailed sa PSO.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yes. So how many how about si andiyan ba si Emmy Ubales? We have invited her as well, Mr. Chair, to be a part of this hearing. Andiyan ba? GM Garma, don't you think it's quite unethical for a general manager to put all mga cousins, daughter, in-laws,
Mr.
as
Chair.
Part of your circle in the PCSO?
Mr. Chair, the positions that were given to them, ang requirement lang po is trust and confidence, Mr. Chair. Just
okay.
Like anybody in appointed, Mr. Chair.
How about si Igel? Did you appoint him as a legal researcher? Awakai?
Igel.
Siya namamahala
ng... There was we posted the vacancy, Mr. Chair. I think she applied and she was qualified as a researcher, Mr. Chair. She was hired.
Okay, HR. HR. Gusto ko lang malaman sa HR. Si Cynthia Boloy Regudo. Ma'am. Can you kindly sit here?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Siya ba ay na-appoint si Igel Awakai? Siya nag-handle ng STL Core Group, correct?
Mr. Chair, Igelet Awakai was appointed Technical Assistant A.
Technical Assistant?
Yes po, sir.
But what is his position in the operation of the STL Core Group?
With regards to her position sa SCG po, I am not aware of that, Your Honor.
Hindi po kayo aware?
Hindi po, because hindi naman po nanggaling
but,
sa HR.
But siya technical assistant?
Yes po.
Appointed? Why not si Tony Galileo ang na-appoint bilang legal research? Bakit a certain job order in the position of Igel ang na-appoint doon?
Ms. Awakai applied for that position, Your Honor. And he was accepted based on merit.
Sige, okay. Because we will be dealing this in the next hearing, you know. I just wanted to abbreviate this issue. But in the next hearing, we will be discussing it as well. Because there are certain issues regarding the feasibility study of all the STL operation in the whole country being manipulated by this person. Iisa ang template nyo. Submit all the templates of all the submission of the STL operation in the whole country. Because if you can see that that was manipulated to favor some winners, then you are in trouble. No, no, not you, but those who approved that, those winners. Anyway, so, ma'am, si Attorney Paquera, andiyan si Attorney Paquera?
Good morning, Mr. Chair. Present.
Nasaan ka? Attorney Paquera, anong position mo sa panahon ni GM Garma?
I was EA6, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Ikaw si OS. Chief of Staff.
Yes, Mr. Chair, but based on the organizational structure of the office, tatlo po yung EA6.
Tatlong EA6?
Yes, in the office of the General
but
Manager.
But during the time that you were in that office, ikaw yung pinaka-Chief of Staff. Am I correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Lahat ng mga communication are being translated to you, correct?
All from the receiving section, Mr. Chair, yung communications po, sinasala po yan. Tapos the rest that are not a specific person sa akin po, napupunta lahat.
And during that time na nawala ka, ang pumalit sa iyo si Lot Grier.
I have no personal knowledge on that, Mr. Chair.
Kung after siya ang pinalit, yes.
Mr. Chair, nauna sila sa akin.
Yes.
Because I came in sometime in August already.
Oh, sige, Lot Grier, ba't ka nando sa loob? Anong ginagawa?
Garma, Your Honor.
Correct.
Naka-duty deal po ako sa kanya.
So, hanggang sa loob ng kaloob-looban ng opisina na kung saan nagtatrabaho si GM together with the COS, you're still there inside?
Nasa dulo po ako, Your Honor.
Hindi, sinasabi nga ni nandun ka sa loob. Eh.
Opo, nandun sa loob pero yung cubicle ko po, Your Honor, sa pinakadulo.
So, in other words, hindi ka nawawala sa tabi ni GM Garma. You're always there.
Sa tabi niya, hindi kami makapasok.
Are you assigned outside or inside the perimeter of the PCSO?
Outside ng office ni Ma'am Garma, Your Honor.
Okay, sige. I will show you something, ano. Lot, ikaw rin ang nangungontrata ng mga food packs doon? Ha?
Hindi po, Your Honor.
Oh, sige, ha?
Opo.
Be careful on what you're saying. Baka mamaya may mapapakita ako sa iyo. Ma'am Garma, nung nakaraang hearing, we were discussing about the Hilltop property. Di ba? May pinakita ako sa iyong Hilltop property. And you manifested in this hearing that wala kang bahay doon sa Hilltop. Do you remember on November 26 to November 27, 2021, nagkaroon kayo ng team building ng mga female department managers ng PCSO doon sa Hilltop Mansion. Yes or no?
Mr. Chair, it's not...
Yes or no? Nagkaroon kayo ng team building?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Oh, sabi mo, wala kang bahay doon sa ano. So, kaninong bahay yung pinuntahan nyo at nag-team building kayo sa Hilltop Mansion?
If I can explain, yes, Mr. Go Chair. Ahead. It's not my property, Mr.
Kanino
Chair.
Kanino property yun?
But, it...
Kanino property?
That...
Property.
I develop it, Mr. Chair.
You develop it? Why did you develop it? Para kanino?
During that time, Mr. Chair...
Kanino? Para kanino mo dinevelop yung bahay na yon?
Nung una po, detachment po kasi yun, Mr.
Detachment ng ano?
Ng Mobile Force po. When I was
mobile
the city
force
director.
Ng?
When I was the city director of Cebu.
And what is your connection with the mobile force? Kung bakit kailangan i-develop yung bahay na yon? Meron siyang mga glass.
It's ha? Not a mansion, Mr. It's Chair. There used to be a structure,
okay.
Mr. Chair, which I just improved it para po mapakinabangan po, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So,
excuse me, yes, Congressman Darren Fernandez. I think you were asking questions to both Lot and Attorney Paquera. Have you taken your oath?
Not yet, Mr. Chair.
So please, COMS administer the oath, Attorney Paquera. How about si Ms. Lotlot? Lotlot and... Ms. Lotlot, nakapag-oath na ba kayo?
Yes, Your Honor, kanina
okay, so
po.
Okay, so please administer the oath of Attorney Paquera, COMS.
Ms. Marsan, have you taken your oath?
Ms. Rigudo po ako, sir.
Have you taken
not yet, sir.
Please stand.
Those who have not taken their oath, please stand up.
Yes.
Okay.
And please raise your right hand, attorney. Do you solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this public inquiry? And do you affirm your statements you gave a little while ago? So help you God. Thank you. The oath has been administered, sir. Thank you.
Please proceed.
Okay, GM Garma, sinasabi mo, dinidevelop mo yon, inaayos mo yon. So, kaninong bahay yung dinidevelop mo? Kanino nakapangalan yung bahay na dinidevelop mo?
Mr. Chair, we asked permission po na there was a caretaker during that time and it was not only me. ang may mga na-develop dun sa area, there are also other officers.
So, hindi, ang tanong ko, bakit mo siya dinidevelop yung bahay?
Maganda kasi yung place. And,
so?
And naisip ko rin po na malapit din po sa may detachment din po doon. And kasi maraming ahas noon during that time doon nung may mga
police. Sino gumastos sa pagde-develop doon?
Ako po, Mr. Chair.
Ikaw ang gumastos?
Yes, Mr.
Personal
Chair.
Mong pera? O pera ng PCSO?
Hindi po, pera ko po, Mr. Dahan-dahan po.
Magkano ang nagastos mo doon sa pagpapaayos ng bahay na yon? Sa mansion, pool of glass?
Nasa mansion, Mr. Chair?
Hindi, nakita na namin eh. So, sabihin mo na yun kung magkano nagastos mo?
It's less than 1 million, Mr. Chair.
Magkano?
Less than 1 million.
Less than 1 million?
Dahan-dahan.
Oh, sige. Department Chair. Of ano? Department of HR. Attorney Cynthia Regudo. Ma'am, kayong HR. Ma'am, ilan ang pumunta doon sa ano nyo? Sa travel order na binigay niyo po noong November 26 to 27, ilang female department managers ang nag-overnight sa bahay na yon?
Mr. Chair, all of the female
how many?
Department managers. For department, hindi ko po ma-recall.
20? 30?
50. Less than 20, Your Honor.
Wow. So, kung 20 persons ang nandun sa bahay na yon, so, paano sasabihin mong 1 million yung ginas mo sa pag-establish ng bahay na yon?
Can I make a statement?
So, wait a minute. Okay. Attorney Inshong. Attorney Analisa Inshong.
Good morning, Your Honor.
Yes, nandun po kayo sa bahay ng Hilltop. So, siyempre, nandun kayo eh. Di ba? So, invited kayo doon dahil meron kayong female department managers tinatawag na team building ng PCSO. So, kanino ang pagkakaalam nyo yung bahay na yun?
I have no idea, Your Honor. We were just invited for dinner.
Wala ho kayo nababalitaan doon na sinasabi kung sino may-ari ng bahay? Wala ba nagmamalaki kung sino may-ari ng bahay? Ma'am, you're under oath.
Yes, sir. Wala pong kaming mga ibang nakausap kasi we were all just together for the dinner po.
Si Ma'am Agnes Ibera, andyan ba si Ma'am Agnes Ibera? Please. Ma'am Agnes Ibera, were you a part of those who stayed at the house of a certain personality at the Hilltop? Andun po kaya?
Good morning, Mr. Chair. Yes, Mr. Chair, I was one of the attendees.
And sino mga nabalitaan niyo may-ari ng bahay?
Hindi po ako nagtanong kung sino ang may-ari at wala rin pong nagbanggit kung sino ang may-ari.
Sino ba may-ari noon na GM Garma ng bahay na yun?
Mr. Chair, I developed it, Mr. Ha? I developed it, Mr. Chair.
So, sa iyo yun?
Sinabi ko na po kanina po.
Sa iyo?
I developed the area, Mr.
Kaya nga,
Chair.
Kaya nga, kundi naman sa iyo yun. Kasi may bahay siya eh, nakatutulog kayo eh. Mga 20 nga kayo natulog doon eh. Hindi may bahay, correct?
Hindi po, kwarto yung tinulugan na sa higla.
Hindi nga. Siya, what did you apply for it? Is it a residential place?
No, it's not.
Yung buong lugar na yon hindi residential, natulog sila doon? Did you construct a structure?
There is a structure,
merong
Mr.
kwarto, Jan. May sala, may kitchen.
Yun yung old area which I...
Hindi,
I'm
Mr. asking
Chair.
You.
Yes.
Correct.
Yes.
The last time I asked you about the Hilltop, sabi mo wala kang bahay doon. Now, you are trying to tell us that you develop it and you own it. Di ba?
Mr. Chair, yes.
Okay, so, again, stop lying, ano, Mama. We cannot cite you in contempt anymore, but we can't. Okay, Ma'am, eto, tanong ko ulit sa'yo. Nung ikaw ay PCSO General Manager, nagtayo ba kayo ng STL party list?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Nagtayo ka ng STL party list?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Anong pangalan ng, anong ibig sabihin ng STL, party list?
Samahan ng totoong larong may puso, Mr. Chair.
Samahan ng totoong larong may puso.
Yes, Mr. 69,
Chair. 69 sa balota. Sige. Naglagay ka ba ng pondo sa STL Foundation na kung saan siya ang sumusuporta sa STL party list na galing sa PCSO?
No, Mr. Chair.
Stop lying, GM Garma. I know that you put money on that foundation.
No, Mr. Chair.
You put money from the PCSO. You put money.
No, Mr.
Stop lying.
Chair.
I will show you something.
I cannot recall, Your Honor.
Sige. Pakita natin yung ano. Yung una. Pakita natin yung binigay na 2 million. And I will be asking the official of PCSO about the donation that was given by PCSO to the STL Foundation that directly benefited the STL party list. Because sa party list na to, na STL, pinsan mo ang second nominee. Am I correct? Marsan?
Yes,
Hector,
yes,
Marsan.
Mr. Chair.
Tama?
Yes po.
And who is the first nominee?
I cannot recall anymore, Mr. Chair.
Kasi hindi po, hindi mo alam ang naka-assign sa'yo. Wait.
Okay.
Wait. GM. Sino-sino ang naka-assign sa'yo ng mga police during that time na ikaw ay GM? One is Narsolis, correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Second is Lot Griar, correct?
Yes po.
Third is Jeremy. Jeremy, kausapin, correct?
Yes po.
Chuck Borondong.
Yes.
Correct. Sir. And Junjun Ubales, correct?
Yes, sir.
You know the wife of Chuck Borondong?
Yes, sir.
What is the name of the wife of Chuck Borondong?
Yvonne.
Correct. And she is the first nominee. Hindi mo alam? Show it. Yes, police. Yan, tanda mo na. Wait,
yes,
balik.
Mr. Chair.
O, tanda mo na STL Foundation that was created precisely to put the money of PCSO on that foundation and then directly benefited STL party list. Will you confirm it? Yes or no? Pupunta tayo sa malalim.
Opo, yes sir, Mr. Chair.
Okay, go. Next. Para pakita ko lang sa iyo, GM Garma, na yung pagsisinungaling, pag sinimula mo yan sa una, dire-diretso na yan. And that's the reason why when we have asked you to be truthful, we give you the chance. But you never grab it. And that's the reason why we told you during that time, hahanapin namin ebidensya. At ang ebidensya, as a matter of fact, hindi namin hinanap. Lumapit ang ebidensya. Balik mo sa dati. Yan. Gusto mo basahin ko? Hindi. Ito si Yvonne. Yvonne Barandog. Yan yung nakakulay green na asawa ni Colonel Barondog. Colonel Barondog, is Yvonne your wife? Asa si Colonel Barondog?
Good morning, Mr. Chair.
Is Yvonne Barondog your wife?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yes. And she is the first nominee of the STL party list. Am I correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Correct. Sige, balik natin. So, si Colonel Barondog, who was assigned, na detail siya kay GM Garma, they created an STL party list. At yung kinate mo nilang STL party list. And they also created the STL Foundation. Balik natin. Para mapakita natin that 2 million was donated. And I'll be asking PCSO, humanda na kayo PCSO, tell us how much was donated for this STL Foundation. Ang STL party list facilitated through the STL Foundation, through the first nominee, Maria Yvonne Caña Barandog, wait, a check from Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office worth 2 million pesos was turned over to Mandaue City Mayor Jonas Cortez. The 2 million is PCSO's calamity assistance to help Mandaue's recovery efforts. Now, it goes through the foundation. Di ba? Sunod. Next. Namigay kayo ng bahay. Yes. Ang party list na pinangungunahan ni Maria Ibon Kanya Barandog at ng kanyang pinsan na si Hector Marsan, first cousin niya, nag-turn over sila under the advocacy program nila, Bahay Mo Puso Ko sa Barangay Malubog, Cebu City. Will you confirm this? That you donated through the STL party list? Yan yung bahay. Yes or no?
I cannot recall anymore, Mr. Okay, Chair, but recall. If there are documents, I may be able to confirm it, but okay. I can't remember.
We will be inviting the president of the STL Foundation, who is the wife of Colonel Barandog. We invited her. Is she around, your wife? Is she here?
Mr. Chair, we did not receive the invitation.
Okay.
It was only me.
Sige, we will be inviting over. Anong trabaho po ng asawa nyo, Colonel Barandog?
For now, Mr. Chair, a little business entrepreneur, Mr. Chair.
Anong business?
Beauty industry, Mr. Chair.
Can she afford to give houses? Kasi hindi lang isang houses itong nakita ko eh. Limang bahay ata yung pinamigay eh. And I will be showing it. Can she afford to give houses?
Mr. Chair, it was a non-government organization who donated that house, Mr. Chair.
Si anong non-government organization na nagbigay ng pondo para sa pabahay? Can you kindly tell us?
Hindi ko... I will recall, Mr. Chair.
What NGO are listed in your foundation? So we'll be asking for the list of the donors of the STL Foundation. We will go to that. So, sinabi mo that NGO ang namigay ng pabahay. At yan, nakalista yan sa STL Foundation. I'm sure of it.
Mr. Chair, I will...
Speak louder, please.
Mr. Chair, I will retract my statement.
You will retract?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Why? Because you're under oath. Kanino nang galing? Yung pagpapagawa... Kanino nang galing pagpapagawa ng bahay na pinamigay ni Ibon na iyong asawa at pinsan ni General GM Garma?
Mr. Chair, it was... Again, Mr. Chair, it was not... I will correct my former statement, Mr. Chair. It was not an NGO per se, Mr. Chair. It was a group of business organizations.
Who are those businessmen who donated houses?
Mr. Chair, I will recall it, Mr. Chair. But they were the one who constructed the house.
Please submit all those businessmen who donated those houses, no? Please.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
You tell your wife to be here in the next hearing. Sige, pakita na natin yung susunod na bahay na dinonate nila.
Mr. Chair, with the permission of Congressman Dan.
Okay, Congressman Suarez.
Maybe si Colonel Barandog is... in touch with his wife, baka pwede niyang tawagan ngayon at malaman ka agad natin yung mga detalye, Chairman, Congressman Dan, para ma-relay na kagad dito yung mga hinihingi mong mga sources of donations. Because I'm a little bit concerned kasi kanina binanggit po ni Colonel NGOs, tapos niretract niya, sinabi niya naman businessmen. So maybe Colonel... you have your cell phone with you, no? Do you have your cell phone with you?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Do you have it?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Baka pwede mo lang i-text yung misis mo at malaman natin, ha? At may report mo na sa committee ngayong araw na ito. Thank you very much.
Okay, pakita naman natin yung second house that was given by the STL Foundation and the STL Party List. Yan po ay sa Barangay Sudlon, Cebu City. Can you kindly show it? Yan po yung second house na binigay kay Victoriano B. Baguio. At yung po, pangatlo, sige. Isa naman sa Sitio Mambao, Barangay Pamutan, Cebu City. Pangatlong bahay na pinamigay. And then, meron pa pong isa, yung bahay susunod. Pero, pakita na natin yung ano. GM Garma, you remember when I asked you about doon sa lupa na meron ka sa Santa Maria, Laguna? Sabi ko sa iyo, I will be trying to locate.
Wala po akong lupa, Mr.
Yes,
Chair.
Oh. But do you remember also that your STL party list conducted pakita mo nga yun sa Santa Maria, Laguna. Yes. Your STL party list, samahan ng totoong larong may puso, through your first cousin, Edward Howard Marsan, second nominee of STL party list, spearheaded the staging of STL Basketball League in Barangay Parang ng Buho, Santa Maria, Town, Laguna. Wherein, area ko po to eh. And basically, we're still waiting for all the documents that will given to us to establish your ownership of that property. Anyway, Mr. Chair, I'll be asking Commissioner Leonardo, kilala mo to?
Page,
yes,
can
you kindly give this to Colonel Commissioner Leonardo? Kilala mo?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Sino to?
Sergeant Jeremy kausapin, Mr. Chair.
He's si with Jeremy the CIDG. Talks. Kausapin, correct?
Kausapin, yes, sir.
So, kilala mo siya?
Yes, sir. CIDG po siya.
Okay, hindi naman. At medyo hindi na nagsinungalingan. Kilala mo to, GM Garma? Si Talks?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yes, naka-assign to?
Yes, sir.
At hanggang ngayon, nasa PCSO to?
That I do not know.
Yeah, hindi mo na alam.
Hindi ko.
Yes, okay. Mamaya, malalaman mo. Anyway, so,
Chairman Fernandez.
Tapos na po to.
Okay, thank you.
Si Colonel Bilela.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Colonel Bilela, are you the owner of Noy Pits Bar?
Part owner of the one of the Noy Pits.
Yes.
Noy Pits, Mr. Chair.
And you know that being a part of the Noy Pits Bar will entail millions of dollars.
No, Mr. Chair.
How much is your participation on those Noy Pits Bar, which is so popular in Las Vegas, in LA, in California?
Just in Las Vegas, Your Honor.
Huh?
20% in Las Vegas. 20%.
And how much is the 20% that you shared?
200,000, Your Honor.
200,000 what? Dollars?
Dollars, Your Honor.
Wow. And where did you get the money? $200,000?
From my salary in as a police attaché, Your Honor, and my savings, Your Honor.
So, naging police attaché ka sa Washington?
No, Your Honor.
Saan ka naging police attaché?
In the U.S. West Coast, Your Honor.
Okay, did you put that $200,000 in your salen?
Yes, Your Honor.
Can you kindly submit your salen to us?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, so those Noy Pits Bar, no? That was established during what year mo to nabili? Yung po?
2021, Your Honor, nung second year ko doon sa US, Your Honor. Hindi ko po nabili. Meron pong nagtayo po at mga kasamahan ko po. Bali, tatlo po kami. Hati-hati ho kami.
At kayo, Colonel Bilela, dati kayong mag-asawa ni GM Garma?
Technically po, Your Honor, hindi po.
Ano na?
Technically po, Your Honor, kasi ang sabi po ng court, declaration of nullity of marriage kasi yung sa amin. So sabi ng court, there is no marriage to speak of.
Void ab initio.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. All right. But still, you are in contact with her. May anak ba kayo ni GM Garma? If I may, I'm sorry kung na-touch ko yan. Meron kayo anak?
Yes, Your Honor.
Anak mo si...
Angelica, Your Honor.
Angelica.
She was our adopted, Your Honor. Legally.
Adopted?
Legally po.
Okay, adopted pala siya. Okay. Anyway, how many branches do you have? Sa ano? O yung buong 7 ba yan? 5 store?
Magwawalo po, Your Honor, pero isa lang ho ako nag-invest. Doon lang po sa Las Vegas.
Yes, oh, because I asked my friends in the States, you know. Okay. And putting up a business like this will entail you millions of dollars. Malaki eh. Malaki yung Pinoy Bar, ay, yung Pinoy Pits Bar. And this Pinoy Pits Bar is a well-established, you know, na chain of restaurant. And that's the reason why medyo nagugulat lang kami that you were able to be a part, ano? 20%, no? So, maybe soon, Mr. Chairman, we'll be trying to find out, no? Yung pag-apply din po nila doon sa United States about those incorporators. But for the meantime, Mr. Chairman, no? Lastly, may driver ka ba na pangalan Dennis Manalo?
Wala po, Your Honor.
Taga Pangasinan?
Wala po, Your Honor.
Yes, so may resort ka? Ato, ano, Colonel Villela?
Wala po, Your Honor.
Wala, okay, sige, wala. Wala kang condominium sa Amaya, condominium sa may Quezon City?
Wala po, Your Honor.
Wala kayo, ha? And even GM Garma, wala rin sa Amaya condominium.
Hindi ko po alam yun.
Hindi mo alam. GM, meron kang condominium sa Amaya?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Ayun. Ko lang naman meron pala dun. So, si...
If I may, Congressman Fernandez.
Sige.
Para lang ano. GM Garma, magkano ba sweldo ng GM ng PCSO?
Yung salary lang po, parang salary grade 29, mga umabot po ata na parang 300 noon. When I left, it's almost 400. Hindi pa po kasama yung board meeting allowances and mga draw allowances.
So, so PCSO General Manager earns roughly around, anong ballpark figure ka?
Buwan-buwan? Mga more than 300 siguro or
ganun so, mga po. 300,000?
Parang hindi ko na. Bakit? And dung later part, parang there's an increase. It's quite high, Mr. Chair.
But I was asking you kung ano yung salary grade nung ikaw ang GM.
29, I think.
Okay, salary grade 29. 30. And it seems na sa salary grade 29, parang ang dami mo masyadong properties. Meron ka ba ibang negosyo?
Meron pong farming yung father ko po. Ako po nag-handle.
Ano yung pina-farm nyo doon?
May mango and ano po, sa bukid po. And when my mother
mango
died.
Farm.
Yeah, and when my mother died, ako po nag-handle sa ano po lahat ng tatay ko, saka ng mother ko sa mga savings po nila and assets po.
So malaking ektarya siguro yan? Ilang ektarya yan?
Hindi naman po, Mr. Chair, tama lang. Ang bulk lang kasi ng nakuha namin is yung naipon ng mother ko jewelry because since I was 7 years old, hanggang college ko po, nasa ibang bansa na po yan. So medyo substantial po yung naipon.
If I may ask, are you married to Colonel Villela? Are you married to him?
We got married, yes. Mr.
And then,
Chair.
Legally separated kayo?
No, Mr. Church, old po.
So, are you aware that he's getting $200,000 as his salary as the attaché? Alam mo ba yun? Noong nagkahiwalay ba kayo, naghatian kayo ng properties?
Wala po kaming hatian ng properties, hindi namin ni-resolve.
Pero meron kayo napundar na properties?
Meron din
nagsasama.
Po, Mr. Chair.
Ano yung mga yan?
May bahay, may lupa, and then there's savings, Mr. Chair, kasi po, our marriage was 2008, and I think he also worked sa America during that time. So, may mga naipon po, substantial amount, Mr. Chair.
Okay, sige, salamat. Colonel Villela,
Yes, sir.
Where were you assigned?
Currently, Your Honor, I am the Deputy Director for Information Technology Management Service, Your Honor.
And what was your assignment where you said that you earned $200,000?
Accumulation po, Your Honor, when I was the police attaché.
Ilang taon yun?
Tatlo po, Your Honor.
Sa tatlong taon, you were able to accumulate $200,000?
No, Your Honor.
Oh.
Apart, Your Honor.
Anong apart?
Yung Yung pong investment ko po doon, yung kalahati noon, naipon ko po doon, yung kalahati
no,
din
no, no,
po.
No. Kanina tinatanong ka. Sinabi mo, tinanong ka ni Chairman Dan eh, meron kang $200,000 ka mo. And you said that this was a salary that you were able to get when you were assigned in Cyprus. Were you assigned in Cyprus?
No, Your Honor.
Yung sinasabi mo kanina, in diplomatic...
In the United States, Your Honor.
So, sa US. And you earned that much, $200,000.
Hindi po, Your Honor.
Oh, eh, ano yung saan ang galing?
Kalahati po noon, Your Honor.
So, $100,000.
I am our salary there, Your Honor. Allowances.
Hindi nga.
$8,000, Your Honor,
mo,
per
Kernel,
month. $8,000 per month.
Ulitin ko yung tinanong ni Chairman Dan, ha? Sabi niya, meron kang $200,000, di ba? Is that correct?
Hindi po ang ganyan ang pagkasabi niya, Your Honor.
O sige, sabihin mo sa akin kung ano niya sinabi niya. Sige, sabihin mo sa akin.
Kung magkano po yung aking binayad doon sa aking share na 20%, Your Honor.
Hindi yun, hindi ko naman. Gusto mo, Secretariat, can we get the records, the transcript during that time when he answered that question, ha? Kernel.
Yes, sir.
Makinig ka, ha? Ang tanong sa'yo kanina, sinabi mo, meron kang $200,000 because you earned that where? Yun ang tanong ko.
Opo, Your Honor.
Oh, ngayon naman, opo ka na. Meron, totoong $200,000.
Opo, Your Honor.
Okay. Saan mo nakuha yung $200,000?
Yung kalahati po noon, Your Honor, sahod ko po na accumulated as police attaché.
Okay, as police attaché, 100,000. Kalahati, come on, di ba?
Opo, Your Honor.
So, how much are you getting every month as a police attaché?
$8,000, Your Honor.
So, accumulation itong 100,000.
Yes, Your Honor.
Ilang years ka na-assign?
Tatlo po, Your Honor.
So, sa tatlong taon, naka-accumulate ka ng $100,000.
Opo, Your Honor.
O, eh, yung $100,000 na extra...
Sa mga negosyo ko po dito, Your Honor.
So, lahat ito, in-accumulate mo in a span of 3 years?
Hindi po, Your Honor.
For ang gulo my, mo kausap eh. Alam mo, ang gulo mo kausap eh. $200,000 ng pinag-uusapan natin. Huwag ka na lumayo doon. Eh, kaya nga ang tanong, saan galing yung $200,000? Sinabi mo, kalahati noon, galing sa sweldo mo as police attaché because earning $8,000 per month. Sabi mo, ha?
Yes, Your Honor.
Kasi i-accumulate mo yung 3 years mo as police attaché, ang ibig sabihin nun, kinita mo yung $100,000, hindi ka gumastos?
Gumastos po, Your Honor.
O, kita mo, ang labo nung sagot mo. Pakiayos nga, I just want to get the transcript, ha? Babalikan kita mamaya, Colonel.
Okay, Chairman. Chairman, can follow up lang ako dun sa mga years. Kompeta, short lang. Colonel, will you allow me? With indulgence of Chairman Dan.
Congressman Fernandez.
Yan ito po. Kailan ka ba na-assign doon sa US?
2020 po, Your Honor.
2020 month. Anong buwan? Anong buwan?
August po, Your Honor.
August, so half of 2020. Now, when was the Noi Pits was established? Last best?
2021, Your Honor.
2021. Of what month?
Nag-start po, Your Honor, December.
December, December 2021. In short, from 2020 to 2021, yun yung na-accumulate mo in the 3 years of your salary and your allowances. Eto ah. Ba't tumatras ka? Tinatanong kita. Do you confirm? Kasi yung data mo is 2020 August, tama?
Yes,
you were signed now. Yung Noi Pits was established December of 2021. So, ilang buwan lang yun?
Yes,
tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, bakit sinasabi mong half? Half of your salary.
I will submit the...
Ito, you're lying. Huwag kang mag-sinungaling, Colonel. Akala mo dito, yung mga tao dito, yung committee bobo, na hindi pwedeng isa-isahin? You have said on record when you asked by Chairman Barbers that half of the $200,000 came from your salary. And your salary, 2020 August, you started there being assigned, and 2021, hindi ko pa sinasabi yung expense mo. Yung expenses mo. Paano magiging half of that? How can you earn $100,000 a month for just 1 year or less? You're lying.
Mahigit po, Your Honor.
Ano mahigit? Sige nga, kwintahin mo nga. Alam mo, yung 3 years mo, kung tama yung sinasabi mo, that's only 288,000.
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, I bet you started August 2020 and December 2021, saka kayo bumukas. Oh, yung expense mo, lahat-lahat. Oh, who are those, ano? Ito, Colonel, marami pa kaming tatanong sa iyo. If, and the next topic, pag nagsignaling ka, eh, baka mapakontem ka.
I'm very willing, Your Honor.
Oh, you're very willing. Okay. Now, sino yung mga incorporators?
Mga...
Sino mga?
Ray Perez po, Your Honor.
Sorry?
Ray Perez and...
Sino nga? Laura sino Colonso. Nga?
Ray Perez and Lauro Colonso po, Your Honor.
Filipino?
Filipino-Americans, Your Honor.
Oh, saan naka, ano, address?
Doon po sila base, Your Honor.
O nga, saan nga doon?
Sa California po, Your Honor.
California? Saan sa California?
In
where?
Los Angeles, Your Honor.
Saan nga?
Los Angeles po, Your Honor.
Oh, Los Angeles. Now, how did you know these people?
They were my brothers, paternity brothers, Your Honor.
Paternity brothers?
Yes, Your Honor.
O, anong trabaho ng dalawa? Doon?
Restaurateur po si Mr. Colonso, Larry Colonso, Your Honor.
O, yung Noy Pits, di ba?
Matagal na po yan, Your Honor. 2013 yan nag-umsa.
2013? Sa, pumasok ko lang 2020?
Opo.
2021, December?
Opo, nung mag-open ho sa...
Sa Las Vegas?
Las Vegas, opo.
O, please... Eto ah, Mr. Chairman, I move to for Colonel Villela to submit his salen in the year 2019 up to 2022, Mr. Chairman. When was the last year you were assigned in the U.S.?
Last year, Your Honor.
When was that?
2023.
2023?
September po ako na uwi, Your Honor, dito.
2023 September?
Yes, Your Honor.
Also, you submit in this committee your salen from 2019 to 2023?
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman, point of inquiry.
What is the inquiry?
Regarding dun sa $8,000 na natatanggap ni Colonel Villena, is this taxable? In the U.S., how is the money received?
Yeah, I believe so, Your Honor, that is a taxable. That is the gross amount of the salary. That
yung
is
ba given. Yung buong amount o yun yung take home mo, Colonel?
Buong amount, Your Honor, dito po inaano yon, binibigay sa amin, inapadala po doon, plus yung sahod ko po as a Colonel, Your Honor.
So hindi taxable yung $8,000?
Dito po, Your Honor, hindi po.
Ah, hindi. So dito kasabay ng sweldo mo pinadadala buo. Ganun.
Yes, Your Honor. Nandito po sa land bank po. Dito po okay. Pinapapasa.
Thank you very much. I just wanted to get clarified on that. Thank you, Sir Chair.
Thank you, Congressman.
Sir Chair.
Please proceed. And
okay, matapos na ako. Okay.
Please rapidly.
Colonel Villela, were you a former finance officer ng PNP as controller ng PD sa Iloilo?
No, Your Honor. I'm the Provincial Director of Iloilo, Your Honor.
Hindi ka naging finance officer?
Never I was assigned in finance, Your Honor.
You were assigned?
Never. No.
Never? Never. Okay. Mahilig ka rin sa mga Rolex? May Rolex ka?
Meron po, Your Honor.
Ilan ang Rolex mo?
Isa lang po. Regalo po sa akin, Your Honor.
Isa lang? Sino nagregalo sa'yo?
My wife po, Your Honor.
Ah, yung wife mo ngayon? Okay. Kailan natin nabili ito? Nung panahon na tayo nasa police attaché?
Opo, Your Honor.
Okay. So, basically, nabawas yung... Anyway. Meron ba kayong property sa Samal?